remember the very day 3 years ago. I still clearly remember it because it changed every part of me. 3 years ago, my parents announced we were going to a place called Tashkent in Uzbekistan. And my first response to this was puzzlement. Tashkent, Uzbekistan, I was clearly lacking geography skill and had no idea where the place was. I was worried and scared of living the place I knew so well and felt so comfortable in for so many years, living behind my friends, school, and everything familiar to me. And yet, what worried me the most was being enrolled in an international school with English as the language of instruction. What would it really be like? What friends would I make? Would I make any? And how would I adapt to the new school and community? With all of these in mind, I arrived in Tashkent. And I still remember the very first day at Tashkent International School. On the first day of school, I really wanted to make a great first impression. So I wore the sweatshirt that I liked the most, and I kept asking my mom whether I looked fine or not. But my plan to make a nice first impression was already over even before I tried, because I soon found out that my other classmates already had a fixed cultural stereotype toward me based on other Korean girls in my grade. They expected me to be very good at math, and once they realized I was in the standard level math class instead of the extended one, it went like this. Hey, you're Korean. This is standard level math class. You're not supposed to be here. You're supposed to go to the higher level math class. I'm sure it wasn't meant to offend me, but it made me wonder, is this what we call a cultural stereotype? To clarify the definition, I decided to do my own research into what constitutes such a stereotype. And cultural stereotypes happen when an individual or a group of people have an idea on another person or a group based on where they're from or the language they speak, without getting to know the individuals. So if I take the definition into consideration, should all Korean girls be in extended math? And I had just experienced my first cultural stereotype on the very first day at TIS, however. This was only the beginning of many more that followed me. At the end of the first semester of my first year at the school, I was the only Korean girl not receiving an honor roll at the Special Awards Assembly. And honestly, I didn't care about not being on the honor roll because I was simply just me, Chemin. But I guess it mattered to some people. And why? I'm not sure. At least one person asked me why I was not getting an award when all other Korean girls in my grade received one. Maybe this person expected me to get one because my twin sister also received it. And at that time, I didn't take others seriously when they compared or expected me to be like other Korean girls. So instead of telling this person to stop comparing me with them, I just laughed and said, well, I guess my academic performance wasn't good enough to receive the honor roll. And if this conversation had never happened, I may have never contemplated who I am. I may have never needed to think of who I should be or who myself is. But after this conversation, or should I say, the incident, comparisons with other Korean girls kept following me, and I started to have the questions of the individual I am. Because people saw me not as an individual person, but as part of a group that they had preconceived ideas about. For instance, when I talked in English with others, one person said, you're a Korean girl and you speak English better than I expected. When I talk with others a lot and make jokes with them, one person said, you're a Korean girl and you're active, talkative, and funny. And when I didn't really study hard or didn't really put all of my effort into the academics, one person said, you're a Korean and you're not so into academics. You're a relaxed person, although you're Korean. You're different from other Korean girls. Getting constantly compared to other Korean girls, I started to be self-conscious and felt like I have to be like others. And I thought, in which aspect am I different from them? And what do I need to do in order to meet others' criteria or expectation? Thinking more about this, I started to feel as if I was not being perceived as an individual person called Chemin, but instead as just one of the Korean girls whose name is Chemin. I felt that Korean was following me all along like a price tag, whatever I did or thought. I was constantly compared. I felt lost and disorientated. What was my identity? So I tried to be different from other Korean girls, and by differentiating myself, I thought I could be perceived as the individual I am. I felt like others would finally accept me as just Chemin, and that there would be no more cultural stereotypes or expectations or criteria. Yet, ironically, I also wished to be more like the preconceived idea. And you guys may wonder, what is this supposed to mean? And what I'm trying to say is that part of me really wanted to hear that I'm like the others. When we go abroad, for instance, we tend to want to meet and socialize with others who share the same culture, like language. This provides them a comfort zone, and this also applied to me. I wanted to use my mother tongue with Koreans, and I wanted to share funny jokes that only Koreans can understand. I wanted to share stories and do other things that only Koreans can understand. I wanted to fit into my Korean group, who shared the same culture and the same language. So the irony of this made me ponder how to respond to what I had experienced, because I didn't want to be perceived as just another one of the Korean girls, but as an individual person with my own likes, dislikes, and ideas. I try to be different from other Korean girls, but no matter what, I'm Korean. And while Korean represents my cultural group, however, it does not define who I am. It does not define my individuality. And that was the aha moment when I realized that I just have to be myself. Just myself. I didn't have to do anything to be different from Korean girls, to be perceived as an individual. Neither did I have to try to fit into the Korean group. I just had to be myself. With the non-Korean friends, with my Korean friends, with all others around me. And I'm not trying to say that cultural stereotypes are always bad and wrong. In fact, it's only natural that we tend to relate certain characteristics or features when we think of certain cultural group. But what I'm trying to say is that don't let these cultural stereotypes define who you are. And while Korean cultural stereotype may still follow me in the future, it is up to me, and only me, to try to break it by being me. So to all others out there, what if cultural stereotypes follow you? So I say to you all, have the courage and to be yourself and to break the mold.